Today's storybook is called Snow Angels by Angel Randall and by Brandon Dorman. Stay tuned until the end of the storybook for a very special surprise for you all. "Help me," cried a voice outside my window. I looked to see my friend Crystal stuck in the snow up to her waist. I quickly dressed in my snow gear and headed out the door. I grabbed her hand and pulled with all my might. Suddenly, Crystal burst out of the snow, and we both flew head over heels and tumbled down a snowy hill. "Now we are both stuck in the snow. I guess we'll have to call for help," I said. "Who are we going to call, snow angels?" Crystal joked, unable to move. "That's a great idea," I said. Cupping my hands over my freezing face, I whispered, "Calling all angels." A winter breeze swirled around us, and before we knew it, snow angels from every direction helped us move our arms and legs up and down, in and out. Soon we were able to move the heavy white snow that surrounded us and then stand up. "Thank you," we shouted. "You are very welcome," said one of the snow angels. "We are glad you asked for help. Not many people ask these days. We are always willing and ready to assist." As quickly as they arrived, the angels vanished. "Whoa, did you see those angels?" "Wow," said Crystal, "that was amazing." "No kidding," I said. "It's too bad that hardly anyone calls for help. Maybe people get too busy, or maybe they think they can do it on their own." "Yes," Crystal nodded. "Or maybe people don't believe like you believe. If people knew that snow angels were this close, I bet they would always call out for help." "Maybe we can make a difference," I said. "Let's be snow angels today. Come on, I have an idea." We raced down the street to a neighbor's home. Before we knocked on the door, we both made snow angels in front of the house and then rang the doorbell. Just as our elderly widow friend answered, we began to sing Christmas carols. "Thank you for thinking of me," said the older woman. "You two sounded like a choir of angels." We realized that we could see the angels, but she couldn't. We giggled, waved goodbye, and ran down the street. Sitting on a bench all by himself was Jimmy, a neighbor boy. "Hi, Jimmy, what's up?" I asked. "Nothing much," Jimmy said. "I wish I had enough money to buy a sled. My mom told me to have a bake sale, but I'm not very good at baking." "Maybe we can help," I said. Crystal and I knew just what to do. After making another set of snow angels, we went right to work inside my kitchen. Before long, we were measuring and mixing, beating and baking. Gratefully, we weren't alone. Jimmy was still watching his friend sledding down a hill when we returned with lots of yummy treats and baked goodies. "Wow," said Jimmy, who soon had a long line of customers. "I can't believe it. You must have had an army of angels helping you." We glanced sideways at each other and giggled, and then we ran down the street still smiling. We saw a sign in a church window that read, "Quilters needed, volunteers welcome." We quietly stepped inside and saw several quilting frames set up. Ladies were sewing and trying each quilt. We knew just what to do. After rushing back outside and flapping in the snow, we were ready to help. We knew we brought other helpers along. "Do you know where these quilts are going?" asked one of the quilters. We shook our heads. "They're going to an orphanage. Helping other people makes us feel like a bunch of angels, doesn't it?" Crystal and I winked at each other and giggled softly, remembering all the good we had done that day. That was the day we decided we would be angels all year long. The end. That was a sweet angel storybook. Check out this special surprise, soft snow angel sugar cookies. Sounds delicious. Take a snap and share the recipe. Give a thumbs up for this sweet story. And don't forget to subscribe for more great read aloud storybooks.